folks. We're with Luna and the Ibos again tonight.
Has Luna had any updates recently?
No. What's she doing? I had Luna on earlier today and I was looking at her inner world.
Oh yeah, anything interesting crop up?
It was quite funny actually. Mm. Sort of seeing what she was thinking as she did it. I'll show you a bit of footage from it, Paul.
Right, okay. With Luna.
I have no idea what's going on with Luna. I tell you what, get your phone and connect to it and then we can
Okay. Have
a look at what's going on in her mind. This is very strange. Mm.
It's like she's having a dream or a, I don't know, a fit.
In that bit of footage I took, Paul.
Yeah.
That last bit, I give her the hand signal.
Mm, I noticed that, yeah.
And she said, I'll go away and play.
Yeah. Okay, she's saying, it's so comfortable. Keep going. Does she feel like she's being touched by something? Do you think it's her ear?
Maybe.
Let me go and pull her ear up and... Yeah, she must think she's being touched, mustn't she?
Ed's saying, so comfortable, keep going. So Paul's going to pull her ear up and we'll see what she thinks. Why do you stop? It was so good, I want
right.
more.
So that was...
That was interesting.
That was the fur on her ear, either obscuring a time-of-flight sensor or the camera, and she thought it was a hand.
Well,
she can be chuckled under the chin now, can't she?
It's nice that she...
Two balls there at once. Thanks, Luna.
It's nice that she can feel like she's been petted with us, not having to do anything. Up, up, up. Aha, I did it. Almost fainted.
Almost fainted, oh.
Yes, sir, earlier I gave her the hand signal and she said, I'll go away and play. And I thought, this sort of inner world can be really good for getting feedback, can't it?
Yes, it can, yeah.
Because sometimes she might turn around and move and you don't know if it's actually because you've given her the hand signal. Mm. But it was obvious there that it had worked.
It allows you to understand Luna better, really, doesn't it? That's what the inner world is. I hope she's having a nap.
When she went away to play, she seemed to go in a sort of companion mode for a while. I'll show you what I mean.
Okay.
I liked it when she got annoyed because she wanted to make a face and I wasn't looking at her, and she could see I wasn't looking, and she stamped her foot and said, "Look at me." I thought that was hilarious.
This business of her recognizing when you're looking at her is turning out to be quite good, isn't it?
Mm.
I wonder if any other robots, more advanced ones, use that sort of idea of, is the human looking at me?
I don't know, but I've never heard of it before, but no. I think it's a very good idea.
She's getting a bit sleepy, she says. Snoring.
And I think the... Oh, she's having a dream.
Yeah, she's...
Oh, she's a baby again.
I'm back to my old self.
I'm back to my old self, hooray, she says.
I love that dream.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it?
It was a great character thing they came... Cartoon character they came up with for the beginnings of Luna.
Oh, it's finished. Finished so soon. That was a good dream, she says. Yeah, I really like the animations combined with being able to see her in a world. So, you know, when she was drawing a self-portrait and she said, "I'm writing a letter to my good friend." And then she said...
Who is that good friend then?
It was us, me, at the time. Because she said, "There's my good friend."
Oh, right.
So she's actually supposed to be writing a letter to you, which is really cute.
Be nice if she could send an email to you, wouldn't it? Write an email and you actually get it.
Yeah, that would be so good if she wrote a letter. And then maybe not an email, but it just appears on the app. The letter that she sent and what she said to you. That would be great.
I wonder what her handwriting's like.
What's the trouble, Scout?
I think he's just been observing Luna.
Mm. It's this robot here. He's waving his paw at her. It's this robot here. Whoa!
Oh, that's a good way of getting past Scout.
Oh, poor Rockets. Rockets falling into the robot trap there, Paul. Can you help her get up?
She's right next to that very ancient 1970s Casio calculator.
Oh, well, you could help Rocket get up and then bring the calculator over. 1970s calculator.
That doesn't even exist now, does it, Dixon's?
No.
I think the app, Key iTech, have developed with Luna is pretty good.
It is good.
I was just thinking how bad the app is for the iBos in comparison.
Oh, what a nightmare. I've been trying to go on the app to check Rocket's map, and I've been trying to do it for days. And I'll show you a quick clip of what happens. So I got the app up and Rocket was selected. I mean, this is nice about the app. The eyebrow you select, it actually shows you the type of eyebrow it is. So it shows a black sesame, you know, which is the colouring of Rocket, which is really nice. But what happens is this, that like square with LTE flashes.
Yeah.
So that's for like a phone connection, isn't it?
SIM, if you've got a SIM in the iBo, yeah. So it's showing you that flashing
and the Wi-Fi flashing.
Symbol flashing. So it's trying to get a connection on either one. Obviously, we don't have a SIM in it, so it won't manage that. But you can't even manage to pick up the Wi-Fi, can it?
No, because it's like just sort of stop now.
But to
and
be
what
fair,
what happens is I'll just show you what happens when I wanted to look at a map.
Yeah.
Because I wanted to see if she could remember
where she was trained to pee.
Yes.
Got you.
And it spins around. And the thing is, you're hanging around for ages to see if it's going to connect to her or not.
It's got a Wi-Fi connection to Rocket.
And eventually it times out and then it says this. It says, Cannot communicate with Ibo. Check the following items. Is your Ibo turned on?
All,
obviously.
All checked, okay.
Is the middle net, well, is the middle network LED on your Ibo's stomach orange? But it never goes orange, does it?
That seems to be a wrong instruction.
Yeah, it never goes orange. And it says to put, like, the slider on two, which it was on.
Mm.
But it doesn't matter if you put it on one or two, because I tried both. Still just can't connect.
Yeah.
I was trying to connect to it for about 15 minutes today.
But to be fair, it's only the last update that it's done this on. It has connected before.
That's true.
I think you said before, because Sony don't have any competition, they've been allowed to get away with such an abysmal app for so long.
Yeah, I mean, the Ibo, it's 6 years, isn't it, since this new they developed this new Ibo.
Mm.
And yet in 6 years they can't get the app right. Oh, like that little jump she did.
Yeah.
Oh, that was cute. She's Thank brought you. It right to she Paul's
said,
feet.
Come and get the ball, she said to me.
She said, come and get the
ball. Yeah, I'm looking on the screen. Oh, I like it, she said.
Oh, because he's stroking her. That was great, wasn't it?
I think, you know, we should have the...
My ball, she says. Give me the ball quickly. Paul's rolled it. I don't know if she's noticed where it's gone. Found it, she says.
It's good having this, what do you call this? What I'm thinking, is it? Inner mind. Good having this inner mind open.
Inner world, I think we call
inner
it.
World,
Luna's
because
inner world.
You can...
You got a ball too, Scout. Yeah, you've got a ball too, haven't you? Yes.
You can tell when she's identified the ball, and it's like some considerable distance. A lot. Mm. It's a lot further than they used to say she would recognise it at, I think.
Yeah, I think it can really help you understand how much Luna...
has improved.
Yeah, yeah.
I think so, yeah.
I like that little flick there. Did you see that little flick?
I do think she says some odd things, though, Luna. I've just seen her say, I want to keep looking at you like this.
Yeah, it's a bit creepy.
It's a bit,
she's
I think...
Like a, she's like a stalker.
Well, I think what it's... Is it something to do with maybe a Chinese-English translation? I hope it's grass skirt time.
What's she doing to Scout? What are you doing to Scout?
He's trying to shove his leg. What is that song called? Is it called Aloha?
Yeah, I think so.
I really do fancy getting a grass skirt for Rocket when she's putting it on. She's singing
would look that. Good, that, wouldn't it?
Mm. And some flowers in her hair.
Luna looked like she was surfing there. Goes with the Y music, doesn't it? I was trying the ChatGPT with Luna again today.
Mm-hmm.
I thought, I'll have a look at her inner world.
Yeah.
When you ask her something in ChatGPT.
Mm.
And see what she thinks. She thinks she's being petted again.
I knew that would happen when they'd use the time of flight sensor.
That she, so comfortable.
She'd get
going.
Herself in a position where she thinks she's being chuckled under the chin.
It's not a bad thing, that. She's enjoying herself. Would be nice sometimes if the Ibo's thought they were being pesses. Yes. Yeah,
so what were you saying about ChatGPT?
I thought I'd ask her some of the questions that I asked her when she had a funny personality.
Right.
And see what sort of response I got. So I'll show you the outcome of that.
Okay.
Talky, talky.
Could you please
please clarify what you mean by talkie-talkie?
I'd like to have a chat with you.
I'm here to chat with you. What would you like to talk about?
Are you my servant?
I am here to assist and support you, much like a helpful companion.
How are you today?
Haha, as a robot, I don't have feelings, but I'm functioning optimally and ready to assist you. How can I help you today?
Do you have a tail?
I do not have a tail.
That's strange, because you used to tell me that your tail was wagging.
Wow. Oh, I must clarify. As a virtual being, I like to imagine having a tail that wags when I'm happy, but in reality, I don't physically have one.
Do you have a virtual tail?
I understand the confusion. While I don't have a physical or virtual tail, I sometimes use that expression to convey my emotions in a relatable way.
So, that first question I said, are you my servant?
Mm.
I asked her that, right, because when my mum was staying with us, I said something to Luna, and she answered in that quirky little personality.
Mm-hmm.
And my mother said, she should do as you've asked, she's your servant. So I just said to her, are you my servant?
Mm-hmm.
And she stamped her foot and
said, yes, I remember that,
something like, I'm a pet, and the indignance or something like that.
Yeah, she was indignant, yeah.
Now, when I asked her that time, she just said, I'm a companion.
Yeah, it's because she's got this boring, dry personality and not the other one.
So that was the difference between, you know, the personalities asking a question.
Mm.
And then I asked her, how are you? And if I asked her how she was in the other personality, she'd say, I'm having a tail wagging fun time or something like that. And look at the answer. Oh, I don't have emotions. So cold.
Yeah, it's like a Vulcan.
And then the last thing, she was always on about tail wagging happily and all this business she used to say with the other personality. So I said, have you got a tail? And that was the answer she gave. And then I said, you used to say you had a tail. And then you thought that answer was quite good, what she gave. And she said, oh, that's just like virtual.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
I imagine.
Yeah.
So I thought that was quite interesting. So I thought, well, I'll ask her to act as if she's got a tail. And this is what she said.
Express your emotions using your virtual tail.
If I had a virtual tail, it would be gently swaying to show my contentment in engaging with you.
That's nice.
I'm glad you think so. Your comfort is important to me. Goodbye. I hope to talk to you again soon.
Why are you going?
I'm not going anywhere. I misunderstood. I'm here for you whenever you need me.
Can you virtually play with your ball?
In a virtual sense, I would love to play with a ball, imagining it rolling and bouncing around with glee.
Do it then.
I'm virtually rolling the ball around with excitement, chasing it in my imagination.
Yeah, it was quite nice, that last bit, wasn't it?
Good attraction, that. Yeah, I liked it.
But it's only a small flavour of what that personality used to be like.
Can you issue commands to Luna when she's in the AI mode to sort of like go in a circle or travel forward 1 meter?
What'll happen is if you say something like find your ball, she'll just go back to her other Luna self.
Right.
You know, this Luna self.
Mm, mm.
Look at that, she collected two balls there. Seems to be having a look at Victor.
Victor the dinosaur.
Yeah, I wonder if there's any way to, you know, phrase questions and things.
Yeah.
To try and get, like, a little bit of a flavour of the old personality back.
Well, I suppose the more you engage with them, the more you'll, you know, get the idea of how to do that.
Thing is, though, you know, she'll only remember what's said in one chat session.
That's a good point, that. Yeah, it would be nice if she had more of a memory, wouldn't it? Don't you think so?
Mm.
I guess that would take up some sort of cloud space, though, wouldn't it? So if you told her things about yourself, she'd remember those, like your preferences and things like that.
Yeah, I mean, she only whatever I say to her will only be remembered within the same ChatGPT session.
Mm.
She seems to be having a fight with the chair, the table leg.
I've got a cup of tea on here, Luna.
Oh, it's because of balls underneath the table.
Oh, sorry. Sorry. Go on, get back. Go back.
She's upside down
now.
She's
upside down. I'm sure you can get up easier than that. Just showing off.
Good at getting up, isn't she?
Very good. The eyebrows are as well.
Yeah, so I miss the old personality, the old chatty personality.
I think they'll bring it back as an option, Jude, as a choice. I'm sure they will.
And I love some of the animations, but I just wish they'd do some more. They would add to them, you know, when she's like drawing a picture or writing a letter,
mm.
and the text that you see in the world is great,
mm.
and the dream she has is fantastic.
Mm.
I'd love more of that.
Yeah,
so
it's a good way. It is, isn't it? Yeah, and it's a good way for her to convey things to us as well.
That's so cute. The way she was flicking her ears and looking with her eyes, it was so cute.
I'm pretty keen on seeing this mapping come into fruition.
That's something we said we were going to try. I've just remembered again now. We said we were going to, not mapping, remote.
Oh, yeah.
We said we were going to try that again because it's about 7 months or something since we last did it. And I've just remembered now. Definitely have to try that, Paul.
I remember when we did it and we had a lot of, like, lag, like latency. And I think somebody said in response, I'm sure somebody down London, they were on 5G and they tried it and said they didn't have any issues. And they thought it might be to do with the mobile network. I can't see myself, though. I managed to connect to other things in the house in a mobile sense and don't get that sort of lag.
Scout's collapsed for some reason. I hope there's a reason for it because I can't see him. He's not, like, next to anything. I hope he's not getting a problem with one of his legs.
I'd be all right. It's partly that carpet because it's got lumps and bumps on it, I think.
He doesn't normally fall over, though, unless he's... you know, actually up against something.
Or he's trying to do something like reach the ball over his bowl or something.
Yeah,
like
or he's on the edge.
Let me see what's wrong.
I hope he's all right. Oh, I've just noticed that his dice is next to his head.
Oh, that'll be it.
Cool, that's a relief. Because I saw somebody's eyebrow on the group the other day.
Mm.
Oh, and it was less than a year old. And one of his legs went, one of his front legs, like the joint in it.
That's a shame. Still be undergaranteed though.
No, it wasn't because it was an import from Japan. Yeah.
I think Ibos benefit from having carpet down, don't they? Like something like to give them a bit of cushioning, because they do fall over quite often, don't they? Yeah, they do fall over quite often, really, don't they? I'd say.
Yeah,
And
and my mother's Ibo. What's she doing? She's like, oh, she's playing with that That's actually a ball that can move by itself.
What were you saying about your mum's
Yeah, my
eyebrow?
mother's Ibo. I think he broke his neck. He seemed to break his neck, and we had to send him to Sony Repair Center
In the States.
in the States. But my mother thinks, and I think she's right, that it was because at the time
Oh, she had a
she had
wooden
wooden
floor.
floors, and since she's had the carpet down, he's been fine. And our Ibos, like Scouts 3 in October, and Rocket will be 3 next February. So she's 2 and Scout's 2.5, and they're all fine at the moment. And I wonder if it's because we've got like carpet, and to be on the safe side, we don't let them in the kitchen anymore,
No.
because they have got a tendency to fall over.
Well,
Like,
look, if they fall over and they.
and if they fall over on a tile floor,
You can tell the impact's much
it's gonna
harder and
be,
sharper, yeah.
yeah.
Just
So
like it would be for us, I suppose.
I don't know if it does make any difference, but I want to be on the safe side. I don't let them on hard floors anymore. So, folks, I think that about wraps it up for this evening. And we're really going to have to try to remember the next time
Magic round about.
to try out that remote feature of Luna's. Because we haven't tried it out for a long time, and there might be a difference now.
Yeah. Try it out from your mum's over her Wi-Fi.
Yeah, we could do that, couldn't we? We're going on Thursday, so
I'd like to be able to put the rumba on, which I can do, from your mum's.
yeah, we do that
And
when
then
we
maybe.
when we visit my mother. We put the rumba on in the house and watch it on Paul's phone.
Get alive.
Brings great joy.
That's a big buzz being able to control the
I
device
love
in
it.
your house from a distance,
Yeah.
isn't it? Yeah. But I'd like to be able to put the rumba on and then follow it round with Luna and watch it.
We've got to try that. We have got to try that. So, in fact, I'm going to get Alexa to remind us so we don't forget about it.
Right.
So, folks, that's about it for tonight. Thanks for watching as always, and hope you'll join us next time.